Oh shit!
This is madness!
Big kings!
So back in June, I made the last minute decision to head to New South Wales to compete in one of Australia's biggest spearfishing competitions, the Eden Three-Way, which is a hotly contested one-day event that has been running since 1970. This was my first time ever spearfishing outside of South Australia, so to say I was keen would be an understatement. But I first had to drive 6 hours to Hamilton, where I met up with Blake Riddle, and then drove the remaining 10 hours to Eden. And after the longest drive of my life, we finally arrived. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the video.
First start of the trip is pretty much blowing a gale. It's freezing, but drove all the way down here, so gotta make the most of it. See you in the water.
So for this trip, I was fortunate to be diving off Paul's boat, the owner of Tirelli. And despite the windy conditions, we still managed to find a protected part of the coastline to jump in on. We weren't planning on diving this spot during the competition, and Paul wanted some fish for the freezer. So I was more than happy to help shoot some fish for him. As prior to this trip, I hadn't shot a fish in over 2 months. Well, that's actually a lie. I did shoot one fish, which you'll see next video. Like I mentioned earlier, this was my first time diving outside of South Australia, so it was all unfamiliar territory, with fish I'd never seen before. It was a lot to take in, but there were a few fish I could recognise from videos I'd seen. There were a ton of blue morwong around, which are closely related to the ones we get in South Australia, so I shot a few of them as I know they're great eating. I was also super lucky and managed to tick off the elusive red morwong. So for those of you who aren't aware, in SA there's been a snapper ban for the past 3 years, which means I've never had the chance to shoot one, so I didn't hesitate to shoot this little fella when it came through. What happened next completely caught me off guard. I was actually on the surface taking a piss when all of a sudden a bunch of fat kingies rocked up, causing my heart rate to shoot through the roof. I stopped peeing straight away, turned on my GoPro and did a dive. I was only using my 90 pranger at the time, as I wasn't expecting to see any kings in the middle of winter. So I was worried that if I didn't get a good holding shot, there'd be a high chance I'd lose it. So I knew I had to patiently wait for a fish to present me with a shot I was happy with. Sadly, that shot never presented itself, and I decided not to pull the trigger, as the last thing I wanted was to take a poor shot and risk wounding the fish.
Big kings! Kingies!
I dived back down in the hopes that they'd still be hanging around, but sadly, they were long gone. So we hopped back in the boat, got the flasher and big guns out, and jumped back in, hoping to entice them again. We had no luck though. I should have tried peeing again.
Bruh.
So this was my first time trying out the new Tirelli Taipan carbon gun, and I must say I was blown away by how smooth it shot with the twin 14 bands. I was definitely impressed by it, and just how accurate it was straight out of the box. Anyway, I guess the kingfish gods must have respected my self-control from earlier, so sent through a school of little rats as my consolation prize, and thankfully in my speed spear this time, so there was no holding back. It always surprised me how much fight these fish have, even the smaller models. But far out, I love shooting kings, easily my favourite fish in the world.
First day dive in Eden. Not too bad.
We now had more than enough fish. So for the next few days, I swapped the gun out for a camera and tried my best to familiarize myself with a new species. However, the day before the comp, there was talk of cancelling it due to the forecast, which people weren't too happy with, as it was already cancelled the previous year. Thankfully, in the end, the comp went ahead. However, it was changed from a 6-hour comp to 5 hours. Like every competition, there was a short debrief in the morning before all the boats slowly made their way to the starting point and waited with anticipation of what was about to come.
Thanks, Mark.
So it was about a 20-minute ride to the first spot we planned to dive, and as soon as Paul dropped me in, I got straight to work shooting this blue throat wrasse. On the very next dive, I had a few options. I couldn't decide which to shoot first. There were black drummer, red morwong, banded morwong, but in the end, I chose to take the banded. Next, I shot this big blue grouper. Nah, just kidding, I would never. I shot the leather jacket next to it though. I get a fair few questions about these pranger guns, and honestly really rate them, and highly recommend them if you're just going to be targeting reef fish, as it makes it so much easier to hit and land fish. Tirelli makes some solid pranger guns, and I've been using mine for over 2 years now, and have absolutely zero complaints. I was off to a pretty solid start, shooting these 5 fish in the first 15 minutes. It was all going according to plan, until I drifted a bit too close to the exposed reef while trying to get the drum off my spear, which resulted with my float and drop weight getting taken all the way into the whitewash. There was no way I was just going to leave my float with all my fish. So off I went, slowly and carefully, towards my float to investigate and hopefully try and retrieve it safely. I made it to my float safely and grabbed hold of the line and slowly followed it to my drop weight at the end. But I could barely see it with all the whitewash. Next minute, another set came in though.
Oh shit!
Not gonna lie, I was scared for my life and kicked as hard as I could to get out of there, because I didn't want to end up washed up like my float.
Mission failed. We'll get them next time.
After catching my breath and reevaluating the situation, I waited for another set to pass before I made my way back into the wash. This time I made it further down my line. I could see that my drop weight was caught on the underside of this ledge and wasn't going to move unless I pulled it from the other direction. I was so close to retrieving it when all of a sudden I got picked up and dumped on the reef.
Mission failed. We'll get them next time.
After trying for another 20 minutes and failing every time to retrieve my drop weight, I just made the decision to cut my line and get the hell out of there, as it was getting pretty dangerous, and I was also wasting valuable time where I could be shooting fish instead. So I made my way as far as I could down the line, trying to save as much as possible, as it was actually a brand new float line that I got just for the comp.
My float line. The drop weight got washed up in the rocks.
So after a bit of a break in the boat, I jumped back in and this time went out deeper, a as I didn't want to get washed up again. But I got straight back to work shooting this blue moe. I found a pretty fishy spot in around 15 metres of water, so went down to see if there was anything that would come in. As I waited patiently on the bottom, I could see a little snapper off the distance. It slowly came to shooting range, so I lunged off towards it, but right before the shot, my wrist dipped. I headed down again, determined to get it. It came in for another look towards the start of my dive, but unfortunately my gun wasn't ready, and it didn't come in again after. I was heaps gutted that I missed another opportunity on it. I did a real solid breathe up this time on the surface before going down, as I knew I would need all the bottom time I could get. I once again spotted the snapper off in the distance, and this time could also see a couple bigger models behind it, between the 3 to 4 kilo mark, just sitting still. You might be able to see them, that's if YouTube doesn't compress the quality too much. I waited though, hoping they would come to shooting range. I was running out of air, so slowly started moving towards them, but unfortunately they spooked. 20 more seconds and I reckon I could have got a shot off on one. I really wanted to shoot a snapper, so went back to the boat and swapped out the pranger for the speed spear, so I could get a bit more range. I did a few more dives in the spot, but there was no sign of any snapper. At the time, I realised I was spending way too much time and energy trying to get one species, when instead I should have been looking for other species in shallower water. I knew there were still a few more species I could get, so moved back into the shallows in search of the elusive red moe. I wasn't gonna let him just show me up like that, so I reloaded my gun and this time showed no mercy. I could see a school of lutric out of the corner of my eye, so quickly sorted the fish and went back down. This was my first lutric ever, which I was pretty stoked about. After that I came across a school of small salmon, and I'm telling you, the new Trelly Taipan shoots like a freaking laser, with very little recoil, making it super accurate. It was near the end of the comp when I dropped right next to this little ball fish, and once again got a perfect shot on it, which wasn't too hard as it was barely moving. Before I knew it, the 5 hours was almost already up, and it was time to start heading back to the boat ramp, which was a shame, as there were still a few species I hadn't got yet. Back at the boat ramp, it was chaos, with everyone wanting to retrieve their boats. It was then time for the weigh-in, where everyone would line up with their catch, and had their fish weighed all together to save time. The score system was the same as SA comps, where you get 100 points per fish, and then 10 points per kilo. I only ended up with 7 species, as my leather jacket, boarfish and salmon were just under the minimum competition size. These comps are always such a big learning curve for me. There were a few nice fish weighed in, but this 17 kilo kingy would top it. Josh Green had a real solid haul and ended up taking out the competition with 19 species. Congratulations to everyone who competed, and thanks again Paul for the unforgettable trip.